Welcome to this Transcriptive tutorial going over how to transcribe and create new transcripts for your media files and sequences. This video starts off with Transcriptive installed and licensed and with a Transcriptive account created, so check out our previous video on installation and licensing if you want to learn how to get here. The first step is to log into the account that you want to use to transcribe. Click the menu in the top left of Transcriptive and select Speech Engine Setup, and you'll see the two AI speech engines we currently use for transcribing, Transcriptive AI and Transcriptive Speechmatics, are both available. If you aren't signed in with your Transcriptive account yet, you can sign in on this screen. If you want to sign out and sign in to a different Transcriptive account, exit this menu and click the account icon in the top right. You can click Log Out to log out, and then sign in to a different account here as well. A couple other options in the Speech Engine Setup menu. Speechmatics BVA is an offline transcribing option that's mostly going to be used by large companies. It requires purchasing a license from Speechmatics, and you probably won't ever be using this, but we do support it. We used to have a direct Speechmatics login here to use with Speechmatics accounts, but now everything just runs through your Transcriptive account instead. In Transcriptive 2.0, you can transcribe a clip, transcribe a sequence, align an existing transcript, or batch transcribe multiple files. You need to have Adobe Media Encoder installed, so make sure you have the version of Media Encoder that matches your version of Premiere. If you have a media file like a video or audio clip you want to transcribe, set Transcriptive to clip mode with this switch at the top, and then open your video or audio clip, and you should see the text "No transcript" and your clip's name. And that tells you that Transcriptive is looking at this clip and that it doesn't have a transcript yet. If you want to transcribe a sequence, just turn the clip mode switch off and open your sequence instead. First, I'm going to transcribe this clip, so make sure I'm in clip mode. Select the clip and click transcribe. You'll see the transcribe dialog, which shows you the name of your clip, the length, and the cost of transcribing it. Make sure this information is correct before you submit the job. The cost should be 8 cents a minute, so double check that you're transcribing the amount that you expected. If you've prepaid minutes, you'll see your prepaid balance here, and the cost will be set to 4 cents a minute instead of 8 cents a minute. To learn more about how you can save on transcribing costs by prepaying minutes, check out our video on prepaid minutes. You can change the speech engine here between Transcriptive AI and Transcriptive Speechmatics. The cost is the same for both. If you want your text returned in paragraphs, select Transcriptive AI. If you want a line break after each line, select Transcriptive Speechmatics. We think that Transcriptive AI is slightly more accurate when you're transcribing in English, but both of these speech engines are good. We encourage you to try them both out and see which one works better for you. The next thing to select is language. This tells the AI what language to look for in your audio. Currently, we support 26 languages that you can see on the list here. The glossary is a field where you can enter terms that the AI might not know, like names, technical terms, and the AI will try to use those in your transcript. Results may vary since the AI still has to identify where to use those terms, but if you have a term that's used over and over, it might be worth entering it here before transcribing. The speech engines aren't perfect at identifying when a different person starts talking, but you can set this max speakers option to tell the AI how many different speakers it should be looking for. And the Align Current Text box is for when you're importing an already existing text transcript and you want to sync it with your clip or sequence. In Transcriptive 2.0, you can actually do that for free, and we have a separate tutorial video called Syncing Existing Transcripts that goes over how to do that. I'm going to submit this clip for transcribing using Transcriptive AI. The first thing that happens is Adobe Media Encoder opens and processes the file. It's exporting an audio file of your clip to upload to the speech engine. If it seems like nothing is happening once you start transcribing, it's probably because Media Encoder is still opening, and once it opens, it'll start processing the file. You can see notifications here for each step of the transcribing process, and those steps are exporting to FLAC, waiting for Transcriptive AI, which means the actual transcribing has started, and transcription complete when it's finished. Transcribing usually happens about 4 to 6 times faster than the length of your clip, which means an hour-long clip will take about 10 to 15 minutes on average. Once the job is done, the transcript will return automatically and have per-word timecode synced with your clip. The transcript is saved to your Premiere project file, so any edits you make will be saved within your project. The clip's transcript is also saved as a file on your drive in the same location as the clip. If I open that location on my drive, I see a file with the clip name and _transcript.json at the end. When you save your transcript, this file is updated with your changes, so if you copy this clip to a new drive or just open it in a new project, Transcriptive will be able to read the transcript from this file. Transcribing a sequence works the same way as transcribing a clip. Open the sequence and turn clip mode off. Transcriptive will show the name of your sequence and no transcript. Click transcribe, select your options, and submit it for transcribing. Once a sequence is transcribed, that transcript is saved to the sequence and saved within the Premiere project file. So here's a completed transcript for a sequence. With clip mode switched off, switching between sequences will load the transcript for that sequence. And with clip mode turned on, switching between clips in the project window will load that clips transcript. The last type of transcribing we're going to go over is batch transcribing. This is a way to transcribe a lot of clips at once. Start by clicking the menu in the top left and you'll see three batch options: batch files, batch folder, and batch project. These are different ways of selecting the files that you want to transcribe. Batch files opens a window where you can select multiple individual files to transcribe. Batch folder asks you to select a folder and all of the files inside that folder will be transcribed. And batch project looks for a bin in Premiere and transcribes the clips in that bin. To use this, create a bin called Transcriptive with a capital T and put any clips you want to transcribe inside. Once you select your batch method and select your files, Adobe Media Encoder will process the files like before. And once this is done, the transcribe window will open in Transcriptive. Check to make sure the number of files and cost look correct, select your options like before, and click continue to start transcribing. You can see in the notifications which file is currently being transcribed. When each file is done, the transcript sidecar file will be created next to the clip on your drive, and the transcript will load in Transcriptive when you open that clip with clip mode turned on. And that covers creating transcripts. In the next video, we'll go over how to prepay minutes to reduce the cost of transcribing. If you want a free trial of Transcriptive, send us an email at sales@digitalanarchy.com.